This video will teach you how to trace model execution using the AnyLogic logs. We'll use the product delivery model, which you can find under the supply chain and logistics category in the AnyLogic example models. We're modeling the process of delivering products by trucks from 3 manufacturing centers to 15 distributors. Expand the database branch of the model tree. If you select the Log Model Execution checkbox in the database properties, you'll enable storing information about components and processes of your model. Let's run the model. We'll switch to virtual time to speed up execution and let the model accumulate data. Now, we will examine the collected data. The log item appears under the database node once we've stopped the model. It comprises the model execution logs as well as raw data. Raw data contains the source data for execution logs and is rarely used. We'll briefly examine some of the logs. We're interested in the logs that contain stats in their name, since they hold aggregated information and are quite easy to comprehend. The agent movement stats log shows the following statistics for each agent representing a truck: the distance covered, the total movement time, and the average movement speed. The behavior of a vehicle is defined by the state chart. Let's open the agent state chart stats log to view the statistics on the time spent by agents in each particular state of the state chart. For example, time spent on unloading the trucks or moving to the destination. To find the activity taking most of the agent's time, we'll sort the mean seconds column values in descending order. Click the gray cell below the column header and select Sort Descending. As you can see, our trucks spend the majority of time at manufacturing centers waiting for the products to be manufactured and prepared for delivery. It's time to examine the manufacturing centers. The behavior of a manufacturing center is defined by the flowchart. It works as follows. A production order is received and put into the queue. Then the production process takes place. The manufacturing center seizes a truck from the truck's fleet, and the product is delivered to the distributor. When the delivery is complete, the truck is released, and the production order lifecycle is complete. The statistics on the time spent by agents in the particular states of the flowchart blocks is shown in the flowchart stats time in state log. Sort the values of the block column in ascending order. We've already examined the delivery time statistics, so let's also exclude the corresponding values from this table by clearing the checkboxes next to them. The flowchart blocks are grouped by manufacturing centers they refer to: the first, the second, and the third. We can see that the time spent in the orders queue block is significantly higher than the time spent in the wait for products block, and it's common for all manufacturing centers. It actually means that we have a huge number of production requests queued, and they can't currently be processed. We can also see that the seize block, which is responsible for seizing trucks from the resource pool, was in the wait state for the second manufacturing center only. It means that this manufacturing center had to wait for the truck to return, while the other centers had available trucks all the time. The resource pool utilization log that shows statistics on the utilization of the resource pools confirms our guess. The second manufacturing center's fleet consists of a single truck, which makes its utilization more than 3 times higher as compared to other fleets. Open the resource unit utilization log to view utilization statistics for each individual truck. Use the resource unit task stats log to get more details on truck utilization. It shows the exact number of tasks and the time spent on completing them by each truck. According to the log records, this truck has accomplished about 3 times more tasks than any other truck. On examining the numbers, we can assume that our manufacturing centers lack production capacities. The second manufacturing center should also consider increasing its truck fleet size to be able to deliver products as soon as they're ready. A piece of advice: if logging slows down your model and you don't want to collect the excessive data, you can disable unwanted logs by selecting "I do not need this type of log" checkbox in their properties. Thanks for watching, and don't deny yourself the pleasure of liking this video.